First real flying car will go on sale in 2017. Flying cars will be in the air from 2017 with Aeromobil promising autonomous models. A two-seater flying car which drives on normal roads, using petrol, but can take wing from any open grassy area is to go on sale in 2017. We believe that by 2017 we'll be able to launch this to market, said the CEO of Slovakian company Aeromobil, Juraj Vaculik at the South by Southwest conference this week. Vaculik envisions a future where flying cars fly slightly lower than planes and trips by flying taxi are common. We don't even need airports, Vaculik said. If something like a flying Uber and flying Lyft will be on the market, I think many users will find this a very efficient way to move. The Aeromobil is already in near-final prototype stage and unlike other rivals, meets the criteria both for planes and for road vehicles in Europe, although Vaculik admits there are still some hurdles regarding where the plane is allowed to fly and take off. On the ground, the Czech-built vehicle can hit 100 mph and it flies at up to 124 mph on twin propellers. It can land on just 150 feet of grass, and fly for up to 430 miles. Its makers hope it will change personal transport on a global scale. The car can be used in road traffic anywhere in Europe, and needs just 750 feet of clear road to take off. It's equipped with an autopilot and a parachute for emergencies, and its makers hope it will herald a new age of door-to-door transportation. The makers designed and built the working model in just 10 months and say it contains various groundbreaking technologies which could spark a new age of personal aviation, such as variable angle wings which allow it to take off on a much shorter runway than rival aircraft. The Aeromobil also has toughened suspension, so it can take off from relatively rough terrain, including paved streets or parkland. Its makers have yet to confirm a price tag or release date for the vehicle, but unlike rivals, it is most definitely real, and flying over Europe now. Vaculik admits that the only thing standing in the way is government regulation, both in the air and on the ground. Vaculik says, "We need to match 100 years of bureaucracy in the air and 100 years of bureaucracy on the ground. It's not easy.